So I've got this motor. Came out of a furnace a couple of years ago when I threw out the furnace. But the motor was only a couple of years old. It was other parts of the furnace that died. So there's nothing wrong with the motor, so I kept the motor. But the problem is, it is only a 1/3 horsepower motor. 1725 RPMs, which is pretty good. The kind of neat thing is that you can rewire it counterclockwise or clockwise. I'd like to try my hand at building a 12-inch disc sander. I've seen exactly one website where I've seen somebody who's used a 1/3 horsepower motor. Everybody else is saying you need a 1-horse motor. I thought, why not try it anyways? Worst comes to worse, I've at least figured out the plan for a disc sander, and I can then, you know, look for a 1-horse motor. On the other hand, I'll have some fun. And that's what this is all about. So good. The motor came with what's called a split pulley, so the pulley could be adjusted in width, and I took off the back of it and I reversed the other side and I mounted it to this square mounting block. I had to cut a channel in there so that I can get an Allen key in for locking it onto the shaft. This is a piece of Baltic birch. It's very flat, and testing it so far, it seems to run true and flat. So next step will be to make a 12-inch disc. I made this 12-inch disc out of 3-inch Baltic birch. I thought it would be nice and solid and dense and flat and have some mass to it for spinning. First time I turned it on, I thought the motor was going to jump off the bench. It was just shaking like crazy. And I thought, okay, it's a little out of balance maybe, or wasn't quite centered. So I figured out a way to turn it perfectly round. I just took my little sander over here and put it up against the wheel, spinning it. That made it a little better, only a little better. It still shook like crazy. I'm like, okay, what's going on? Well, it's just not quite flat. If I put it on this cast iron table, which is flat, there's just the tiniest bit of rock. And I'm like, really, is that it? And I thought, well, okay, I had a piece of MDF, which I'm not real thrilled with, but I happen to have a piece of MDF shelving, which is absolutely flat. And I quickly just traced it, and I put it on. And that's pretty smooth. So I'm pretty impressed. Just a little bit about a flat can make a huge difference in how much this thing shakes. Sort of safety cover, dust cover, that's going to go across like that. That's going to be curved. So if I put these pieces here, you have these gaps in between. So I'd like to figure out the angle. The diameter of this circle is about 12 3/8. I'm going to call it 12 1/2. So we take 12 and a half for the diameter times pi. You get about 39 1/4 inches. We divide that in half, since we want half the circumference. Just under 20 inches. All right, we'll see if my math is right. I look at the arc and I think I want pieces about a half an inch wide, so I'm gonna need 39 pieces. And you divide that out and I'm getting 4.6 degrees is the angle that I'm looking for. I need pieces 2.5 inches long, so I need about 105 inches of stock. Well, look at all those gaps. Either my math was off, or my tools were a bit off, or I don't know. But on the other hand, it looks pretty good on the outside, and I'm going to fill the inside with some epoxy once the regular glue is dried. It should be just fine. Well, that turned out pretty good. The outside is nice and smooth. The inside is a little ugly, but that doesn't really matter. This is going to be on the inside and it will be completely hidden. The important thing is that the gaps are all filled and the cover is nice and strong. I can now install this behind the sanding disc. The next steps involve making a basic sanding platform, closing in the base, and adding some dust collection. I think that this is a good stopping point for this experiment. I've managed to put together a functional disc sander and now I just need to live with it and use it for a month or so. That will give me some time to find out how I use it, how it fits into how I work, and how it fits in my shop. I can already think of some future work that I may want to do. Painting it for one thing. I should also probably build some sort of dust shroud for the motor. And speaking of the motor, I still also might want to wire up a switch so that I can switch between clockwise and counterclockwise rotation. You know, just for fun. And then there's the sanding platform. I just made a fixed platform, both for simplicity and because I think that's really all I need. But we'll see if I decide that I need a movable or tiltable platform or not. So the net cost for this project was $5 plus tax, and that's for the 12-inch sanding disc. Everything else was shop scraps and, of course, the surplus motor that I started with, and I'm pretty happy with that. Thanks for watching.